of the Empire State Building.
And the big D, DJ Dramos in the building, live on the ones and twos. Feliz viernes, mi gente. Someone very, very important.
Yeah.
Welcome home, LL Cool J.
Gracias, ma gracias, ma gracias. Yo listo, yo listo.
Yo, ya está, míralo. Okay, you ready. You are so sabe, ready. Huh?
Yeah, you know what I mean? So we in the building. What up, baby?
Man, thank you for being here, man. Thank you for gracing us with your presence. Thank you
Look
for being a part.
Look at how shiny.
Yeah,
yeah, I feel good.
Can't even see. I know a lot of people like to wear fake jewelry.
Yeah.
What's
all fake.
On
everything
no
is fake.
Way.
Yeah, every bit of it is fake.
Okay, I need to borrow that.
Everything, yeah,
that's
yeah.
That's good
yeah.
fake. That's a good
yeah,
fake.
Yeah, that's a good fake. It's a real good fake.
That ain't that Canal Street special, man.
Hey,
we got to dive head first into the GOAT.
Okay.
Just definitely talking about G-O-A-T, that being you. We didn't even use that term until
you
did that for the world, man.
Yeah, so the way I came up with that was obviously Muhammad Ali, you know, famous boxer.
Yeah.
He used to call himself the greatest of all time.
Of course.
Then there was a street basketball player, you know, his name was Earl the GOAT Manigault.
There it is.
And I took the greatest of all time and took the GOAT and made GOAT the acronym for the greatest of all time and introduced it to the world. And I had an album in 2000 and I named the album the GOAT.
Boom.
You know what I'm saying? And that's how that slang or that phrase kind of got introduced to the world. So
don't forget it. The original GOAT.
The original.
Yeah.
Live in studio.
Yeah, yeah,
LL Cool J.
You're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome.
Oh, fam. Man, this tour. Let's talk about another acronym, man.
Yeah.
The Force, man.
The Force.
What's it feeling like for you to, 30 years, man, to hit that stage again and give the world what you give the world?
It's amazing. You know what I'm saying? We're going to be at the Barclays Center on June 27th. We'll be at New Jersey, the Prudential Center June 28th. And it's just, look, it's hip-hop culture. It's not about LL Cool J. It's about celebrating hip-hop culture in a huge way. So if you're a fan of all things hip-hop culture, and if you're a fan of the journey, and if you remember all of the great songs that brought all of the great memories, and you remember getting dressed to this song and getting dressed to that song and half dressed to this song, then these are the, you know, the shows that you want to go to. So between that, we have the Rock the Bells Festival, always obviously on August 5th as well. And all I'm trying to do is really elevate hip-hop culture and just make sure people have fun with it and serve it to people at a real high, high level. Because that's the thing, too. I want people to feel safe and feel and know it's going to be fun and know it's going to be given to them at a high level.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I bring in the Roots, you know, DJ Jazzy Jeff, Z-Trip. They're going to be behind me along with all of these other incredible, amazing groups
Goats
that are being announced.
Only.
Yeah.
Only come out to support LL Cool J. Goats and, of course, we have to say thank you, 14 years NCIS Los Angeles.
Wow.
Coming to an end.
Yeah, yeah. It was an incredible journey. You know, playing that character, Sam Hanna.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to the whole NCIS La Familia.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
It's
and we had fun. You know what I'm saying? It was an amazing journey. So I kind of finished that, and now we're doing this. And then we have a book. It's LL Cool J Presents The Streets Win, 50 Years of Hip-Hop Greatness. And I have first-person essays from all of various artists, everyone from Eminem to Dre to Snoop to to Nas.
There's some names over there that you just dropped. Let's go ahead and pick those up.
Yeah. Now leave them there. Leave them there. I want them to be remembered. You know what I mean?
Is.
And we're gonna put them on the wall. Put them on the wall.
There it is.
Yeah, man. So that's fun as well. So people should check that out.
It's a real situation, man. For you to continue to be there and to watch the culture move. We had the chance to be in studio with Flav, man.
Right.
And this 50 years of hip hop is amazing. And what you did at the Grammys and how you continue to push forward this culture that some thought was gonna die off in 5 or 7 years.
Yeah.
What's it mean to you to see it thrive?
It's first of all, it's real rewarding.
Yeah.
Secondly, it's it just makes you, you know, it just shows you that dreams are real.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? That's the thing, because we can always, sometimes we forget, you know, when you dream a lot of times in life, people don't realize dreams are real.
Mm-hmm.
You just have to really put it all together and construct it and bring it to life. But
sure.
So, you know, hip hop was always as big as it is now in my mind when I was a little kid. You know what I'm saying? When I was, you know, first hearing the tapes floating around in the city. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, to see it where it is now is amazing. And that's why I'm doing Rock the Bells.
So
you know what I'm
saying? What were some of those first tapes that you felt different when you heard them through the speakers?
Man, I mean, hearing the Cold Crush Brothers and hearing, you know, Flash and the Furious Four before they were the Furious Five. And the Treacherous and the Fearless and the Force MCs and hearing Zulu Nation tapes and, you know, Bambaataa, you know, different people. Like, it was just an amazing, amazing feeling, you know what I'm saying? And it was the first time that I heard, you know, kids like me, you know, feeling, sound empowered, you know what I'm saying? Because most of the time, a lot of the stories were horror stories, and a lot of the stories were, you know, it was things that you kind of wanted to get away from. It was like you were bent over walking into a police car, but this was something like where people were talking, when they were bragging, even though they were bragging, it wasn't about bragging because I'm better than you. It was actually, you were coming from like a negative 20 coming up to zero or one, bragging to have, just to be even.
Yes.
You know, does that make sense?
So
that, so that macho-ness and that braggadocio, it wasn't about like trying to rub something in your face. It was underdogs.
It's the growth. It's the glow up was real and you felt it.
You know what I'm saying? So for me, that was an amazing feeling. You know what I mean?
Well, music lovers know that you have contributed so much, not just hip-hop music in general, but this newer generation sees you as, like, bigger than music. We see you hosting. We see you acting. Yeah. We see you as a role model. You're very unproblematic. Like, it's really hard to be unproblematic.
Unproblematic? That's so funny. Y'all want to curse so bad. That's so funny. Yo, that's so funny.
You are, though.
Unproblematic?
Unproblematic.
Unproblematic. Okay. Let me tell you something. I'm a good guy. I'm not a nice guy. So I don't know. All that unproblematic. I don't know. But like let me you know what I mean? But listen, look, I'm clear. Look, a lot of certain generation, they just see me as an actor. They think I'm a host. A lot of them don't even know I make music.
Yeah.
Some of them have heard the songs but don't necessarily tie them together with me. So it's like, that's also a wonderful opportunity too, because I want to show them what's possible. Now, you know, the whole point of me making these new records and making this new album and making this new music.
Wait, hold on. New album?
Album. Yeah.
Did you say that?
Yeah.
Yo.
Yeah. Yeah, I just finished a new album, and I think it's real special.
Oh.
And I think it's, you know, Q-Tip executive produced it for me.
Wow.
And the whole point is to just show people what's possible and show people how, like, if James Cameron can go do Avatar and Tom Cruise can do Top Gun, then LL Cool J can do a new record that's impactful. Not trying to recapture something from a different style from back in the days, and not trying to chase a current style that's happening right now, but actually giving people something that is new. You know what I'm saying?
Where are you pulling influence from now? Like, where, you know, where does the new sound go? Because it is really amazing to that point that you continue to evolve and create and be challenged.
Yeah.
What are some of those new sounds, new things?
So during the pandemic, one of the things I did was I wore my mask and my hoodie and I was on the subway. I was, you know,
that was,
I
was
on
you?
The, I was on, yeah,
you?
I was all over. I was on the
jumping
bus.
Jumping over the turnstiles, that was you?
I'm gonna pay. That I am gonna be unproblematic. We're gonna be unproblematic with that today in the news.
So what,
LL Cool J gets the Bozo Award for jumping over a turnstile like a
bozo.
You know what I mean? Bozo's anonymous. Oh, yo, man. I'm da-da-da-da. I'm a bozo. I jumped over the turnstile. I had money in my pocket. You know what I mean?
Man.
So,
But you took that time during
the pandemic. To really, because look, you can't talk to people if you can't relate to people. Ooh. You know what I'm saying? And the people would assume that I'm like just like lost in Hollywood somewhere. But nah, that's not the case. Like, I absolutely was everywhere, like all over, really exploring the world and getting connected. Because how can you make music and really communicate with people if you can't relate to people?
Yeah.
And it's, you know, and it's, and for people to relate to you, you have to relate to people. You feel me? It's not a one-way conversation.
Mm-hmm. Jim.
You dig?
And
Jim on. You know it. Jim on.
I feel like a lot of those examples that you saw, we're going to obviously hear in your album, but what are some things that really surprised you being in Hollywood for so long and then being back in the subway?
I mean, something as simple as, like, this is going to sound absurd to people who ride it every day, but, like, just no tokens.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Something that simple.
Something different.
I mean, the metros are leaving now, and then we're with our phones now, right? But I'm just saying, something that simple. Mm. Like, those are things, like, you can't make that up. You know what I mean? So there's a certain level of vulnerability, too, that comes with it. Because you have to be able to admit, like, yo, I was out of the loop. You know what I'm saying? But then I took the time to get in the loop and to really pay attention to what's going on. And that feeling, you know what I'm saying? You just get that feeling back, that good feeling. You know what?
What I'm getting from this conversation, you're still hungry.
Super hungry, man.
Yeah, that is so amazing. Because you would think that someone who has accomplished so much would fall into a place of complacency. But, I mean, to see you succeed but still stay hungry, who do you attribute that characteristic to?
Man, I don't know, man. You know, it's, I mean, that comes from the soul, right?
Yeah.
You got to want it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to, you know, I want to hear my record, you know what I'm saying, playing on Z all day long, you know what I'm saying, the new joints. Like, I feel that. Like, I'm interested in that. I care about all of that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? It's not about, like, you know, there's more to life than just money and accolades.
Yeah.
There's fulfillment, you know what I'm saying? And fulfillment ain't about money and accolades. Mm-hmm. You can't, you know, like, you know, you got some people that shop till they drop, but they're not happy. I'm not saying that it's not fun, and I'm not saying that, you know, I know everybody wants to be rich. A lot of people want to have things. I'm not in any way suggesting that it's better to not have it. I'm just saying that there's more to life than just that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, yo, you know, to be able to move around and to be able to, you know, do something that means something to you. You know what I'm saying? Mm. Like, that's fun to me. Yeah. You know what I mean?
We feel it.
I feel like you're challenging yourself and trying to continue to do new things.
Yeah.
On this new album, are we going to hear any features that we probably wouldn't think? Have we heard you speaking in Spanish a few minutes ago? Like, are we going to have any, like, Spanish collabs over there?
I definitely got some real cool features on it, on a new record. You know, Saweetie's on the record. Eminem's on the record. Ooh. You know, there's a lot of Nas. You know, there's some, you know.
And we're talking to real. We're not talking to AI, Saweetie. The AI, Eminem.
Nah. Yeah. Unless you're talking about Allen Iverson. I don't know what you mean. You know what I mean? No. Yeah. You must be talking about Allen Iverson.
Say it.
Yeah. Nah, this is the real. The real. And it's an amazing feeling. You know what I'm saying? It, like, feels like, I think, you know, real special. And I think Q-Tip did an amazing job. You know, and then the tour, the album, the festival, all of these things all come from the heart. You know what I'm saying? And it's all about elevating the culture. So,
man, it's you come from such a strong family, you know, raised right. It's hard for you to believe that your mama said, knock me out. It really
you ain't
is.
Know my mama then. Because it wouldn't be hard to believe at all.
This humility, this grind, what you continue to do is, like Crystal's been saying, like we've been saying throughout this conversation, it's so dope to know that there is someone pushing for the culture, and it is all because of what that fulfillment truly means.
It is, man. I mean, look, at the end of the day, man, you know, the thing that matters the most is how you touch people.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's the thing that really is going to matter the most on a worldly level. You know, yes, in terms of your immediate family, you have to take care of people, charitable things, all of that's great. And it does help. But depending on your platform, how you touch people, you guys do this radio, you know what I'm saying? The way you touch people, the way you make them feel good when they listen to the music, you know what I'm saying? Like, that matters. Mm-hmm. That's important. You know what I'm saying?
Well, it's important for us to see how supportive you are of your friends. Just in Hollywood with Ludacris while he was getting his
Star,
man. Yeah. On the Hollywood Walk of Fame.
Yeah.
How was that for you?
It was incredible because I remember Ludacris when he first started, and I remember him coming up to me and talking to me.
What?
He was younger, when he first got his first songs,
I want to move down to the flow,
and I want to, you make it so, when he had all that, so, you know, all of that, you know, so, you know, so, that was, like, incredible, you know what I'm saying? And to see him go from there to everything with the Fast movies, and then to go Fast and Furious, to getting a star and all of the hits. I mean, I just wanted to be there. So when he asked me to be there, I was actually honored, you know, because that's what we got to do for each other. You know what I'm saying? You got to be there for people. Lift people up, man. I just want to see people win.
I'm going to hold your feet to the fire, though. Have you seen all 10 of the movies?
No.
Okay.
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. You know, if I did, that would be a problem, because that means I ain't busy. I ain't busy enough. I ain't productive. No, I absolutely haven't, but I like some of them. I definitely do.
Yeah.
I definitely do.
Is there any youngins on your playlist that are coming up right now? You're like, they have crazy potential. Like, they just sound different.
I like a lot of artists. I think a lot of these artists do great work. I think, you know, it depends on what it is. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, you landed on the Assistant to Saweetie on the album. I mean, that is amazing.
The way Simba rhymes. I got three artists that are really unknown on my album that aren't known at all in the world. But, yeah, there's a lot of acts out there.
How did you decide that? That's a big thing to put people that
I was on just on IG, and I just was looking and listening to different artists on IG and listening and just got found two of them, and then Tip found one of them. And we decided to put them on this record. I got a song on the album, and I put these three unknown guys, you know, on the record.
Wow.
So, but the album is, I think it's going to be a lot of fun for people, and pure hip hop.
Can you imagine, before we get to wrapping things up, or could you imagine getting a DM from LL Cool J on Instagram? You know
what I'm they don't believe me. They don't believe me.
Please close your contact, because LL's looking.
Yeah, and while we at it, there's only one Ella at LL Cool J on Instagram. Anything else, LL Cool J 4755, LL 1691 with an underscore, hashtag Crown Victorian.
Like, please stop, please
LL
stop.
LL Detective slash underscore Z1 Grubhub. Like, yo, come on, B. So, like, don't ask me. Don't DM me and ask me if I sent you another DM from another account.
Gosh.
Just figure out a different reason to DM me.
There is
not
only
that
one go.
You know? We'll get a response from you on Instagram.
I don't know. I absolutely do not.
Unproblematic.
Yeah, I'm unproblematic. Yo no sé. Okay? Yo no sé.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is pure energy. This is pure family. This is New York in the building on New York Station.
No
man.
Doubt.
The force is coming. Make sure you are a part of this tour. Barclays, Prue Center. Make sure you continue to support the way that he supports. You are that dude, man. We can't thank you enough for blessing us, man.
Nothing
for,
but
for
class.
Being you,
appreciate
man.
You.
Little sass.
New York. A lot of sass. New York.
From the top of the Empire State Building.